Hello, this is Atomic Swift, and welcome to another one of my videos. This one is a better gameplay demonstration of Retropie on a Raspberry Pi 3. I've been playing quite a few games on this. The MAME emulator is good. I showed off a video playing the Mortal Kombats. Let's see, this time, try, I guess, Turtles in Time. This is on MAME. Okay, it doesn't work. Try this one. All right, I forgot what game this even is. Let's see here. Leonardo.
Fire! I'm on it!
So that was Ninja Turtles. Let's see, Turtles in Time doesn't work. Maybe this one will. Okay. Yeah, this one's going to work too. The one MAME emulator, well, two MAME emulators. Dreamcast works, but it runs slow. Let's kick shell! Couldn't get any Sega Genesis ROMs to work, so it's... I figure the button's better, but this one's pretty good. I mean, it kind of looks like shit on a 55-inch fucking TV. It looks a little pixelated. Doesn't look bad on the screen for the ODS, though. Alright. Yeah, so that's Turtles in Time on the main emulator. Definitely playable. I'm back out of that. I think that was the... Yeah, none of these other... I tried Primal Rage... Yeah, Primal Rage wouldn't run. Which sucks, because that game was awesome. Yeah. What a bummer. I can't remember if I tried Mortal Kombat 4. Oh, shit. Yeah. There's so many different revisions, so we'll try another one. Yeah, no. Killer Instinct 1 and 2 would not run. I'm gonna try one more. Oh. All right, it's running the system test. Let's see. If it's got all the files, it should run it. That's what it does on the computer. Sweet. All right.
Scorpion.
This is the arcade version of Mortal Kombat 1.
Fight! Excellent!
Yeah, I gotta configure the damn buttons.
Johnny Cage wins.
Spear to work for some reason. There's no load punch. But as you can see, definitely playable. Mortal Kombat 4. Or I don't know why it says 4. It's Mortal Kombat 1. Now we'll try. Okay, so Mortal Kombat 4. Actually, you know what? One of those other ones was fuzzy like that. Let me see if that one will boot if I let it go past. Alright, yeah, it's Mortal Kombat 2. That's. Dude, I wonder why they're all called Mortal Kombat 4. See if this Mortal Kombat actually has a damn low punch. Alright.
Round one, fight.
Oh, it's God damn, that computer was a cheap ass bitch. And the buttons are, yeah, I gotta have to map the buttons, but. As you can see, definitely playable. You just have to map the buttons. Which I haven't looked through how to map the buttons. I'm sure you can. You can do it on PC. Why wouldn't you be able to do it here? That fucking computer's a cheap-ass bitch. You try to spam moves. Yeah, it's hard with the damn button switched around. But so Mortal Kombat 2 ran pretty good. Yesterday or the other day, I tried 3. Could try some of these Killer Instincts. Different revisions of Killer Instinct when they added updates to the machine. Yeah. That's a bummer. The one that really bums me out is Primal Rage. I had a lot of fun playing Primal Rage. In the arcade and on my Super Nintendo. Okay, so I've showed off Super Nintendo before. That works great. I ran the scraper through it, downloaded all the box covers, which is pretty cool. And it's just amazing in this pack. I think I've got pretty much every North America Super Nintendo game that came out, 764 in the library. I didn't download anything for Amiga. I've never played an Amiga, so. I'm not even gonna lie, I have been playing Atari. Let's see. It's a weird thing, though. The D-pad, I tried it earlier with, Donkey Kong, the D-pad for an wired Xbox controller, Xbox One controller, plugged directly into the Pi, wasn't detecting the D-pad. Let's see, we'll try it though. Space. There we go. It wasn't recognizing the D-pad. So, oh, it is now. Oh, yeah. You gotta configure the buttons on this too. That is cool. They incorporated the system. There was a button on a switch, or like a switch on my Atari 2600, that you could hit to make it bigger or smaller, your little tank thing. But yeah, this is bullshit. I mean, you play these games, and it almost seems like a waste of technology using a Raspberry Pi to play a game from 1978. But as you can see, it runs good. The sound is there. So, yeah, so that's Atari. A lot of Atari games on here. This is, I believe, the Atari whole library, too, in the U.S., so there's 2,548 games. It ran around 10 megs. These are the Dreamcast games I tried. Every one of them ran. Crazy Taxi 1 and 2 was weird. It got to the screen where I could choose to run at a PAL signal or NTSC, and then the game would just like froze, and it wouldn't let you select NTSC. It stuck in 50 hertz PAL, so. Game Gear runs good. I put a few games on here. Earlier I was playing Sonic the Hedgehog, which, let me tell you, going from a Game Gear screen to a TV. I mean, it still looks good over there, looking at it on the OBS, but it just looks so weird on a 55-inch TV. Like, it looks fine on the OBS screen, but God, this shit looks so pixelated. And I don't remember, like, I don't know, for some reason when I remember Game Gear, I remember the Sonic games playing the same as the Genesis, which is not true. It doesn't seem as fast and fluid when you're jumping. It just seems weird, and the whole screen, you know, the screen's obviously smaller, so the game takes up less of the screen. It's kind of weird. But yeah, so that's Sonic 2. But that's Sonic 2 on the Game Gear. Said it ran pretty good. I didn't... Oh, it was Pac-Man for the Game Boy. I didn't put that on. Well, let's see. And then I showed off Game Boy Advance. That runs really good. It's another thing where if you play it on a big TV, a lot of the games look pixelated, kind of like the Game Gear. Yeah, so this is one game I didn't try. Okay, so I mean, it's so pixelated compared to the screen of the Game Boy. There's no way in hell I can play this game. No way. When I made that other video, I think I told it on the I could play it on that TV, 55 inch. This is so pixelated and burning. Like, you expect it to be smooth, like Mario Kart 8, and it's just not. More like. And that's actually giving me a headache the way that game turns. It turns more like the Super Nintendo version. Didn't try anything on the Mac. This is R-Type. I just put one game because I wasn't really a fan of the Sega Master System. Like, I never had one growing up. I got one later on. But it didn't work, so I never really played it. guess. I mean, I never played this game on Master System, so I'm not sure if like the controls are even as responsive as they were in that game. I mean, the game feels fine. I mean, maybe that's good, I guess. Yeah, this is all right. I'm not a fan of these kind of shooters, so that's the Sega Master System. So I'm back out of there. I think I already showed off some Genesis or Mega Drive, whatever. Let's see. Trying to think of it. Game I used to play on here a lot. Let's see. Growing up, I didn't have a Genesis either. I had a Super Nintendo, even though I was a big fan of the Genesis. I didn't have one till later on. Let's see. And the cool thing about this emulator is you can play hacked ROMs. Like, look at this hacked ROM. Like, oh shit, Mortal Kombat 5? No, it's, it's Mortal Kombat, like, mythologies with the graphics from... Look at the Sub-Zero from Mortal Kombat 2 and Kano from Mortal Kombat 3. But, you know, I have to mess with the buttons. No. I have to go through and edit these buttons. I mean, this video is just to show off the emulation, which is pretty good. Try OutRun. This was an awesome game. Back in the day.
Get ready.
Oh my god. See, 16-bit games, they look so shitty on HD TVs, and this is a 4K TV. I don't know if that even makes it look shittier, but my god, it's so pixelated. It I guess it's alright. I can sit and play this shit. It'll give me a headache. Like, the car looks fine, but the road looks pixelated and shit. So does the horizon in front. But, it emulates just like I remember it on the Nintendo 64. I showed off, I think, GoldenEye. GoldenEye runs like shit. It's choppy. Unplayable. Super Mario 64 ran really good. Wave Race was choppy here and there. Overall, you could play it. Try Mario Kart. See how Mario Kart 64 runs. The only thing that I don't like about this... Super Nintendo. I'm sorry, not Super Nintendo. The Nintendo 64 is. I cannot figure out on the controller whether this controller or the Super Nintendo controller. How the hell to back out of the emulator? The other one's just put start and select. You can back right out of the emulator.
Okay.
Here I have to push power cord. The button on the power cord. Okay. So the analog sticks actually, the left analog sticks to steer actually. I played the Nintendo 64 version. I don't think the game is running quite at full speed. Woohoo! I know the turning just looks weird too. Maybe it's just I haven't played in a while, but. I think that. Yeah, so that's Super Mario Kart. I mean, definitely playable. It's pretty close. It's a little slow, and like I said, I have to hit the power cord on the, or the power button on the power cord for this kit I bought. Reboot back in. Luckily, it doesn't take that much time. So Mario Kart ran okay. We'll just say Mario Kart's almost there. I don't know. It felt a little weird. So far, the best game I've had running on the 64 emulator is Super Mario 64. So we'll go back to Nintendo 64. Let's try. Some computer emulators don't run this game correctly. I wanted to try it. This was one of my favorite games. It was WCW versus NWO World Tour. Me and my brothers used to play this game for hours on my 64. Yeah, this was my wrestling game back in the day. The hell did it thinks I have two controllers plugged in, which I don't, so it's not gonna let me start the damn emulator. Oh yeah, okay. There we go. I remember, because you can't. There we go. You know what, the game looks a little slow, but it's been so long since I played it, that might actually be accurate. I mean, if you really wanted to play it, you could definitely play that. Draw. Yeah, it's not registering on the damn menu right there either. Alright, so that was WCW NWO World Tour versus NWO World Tour. For the N64 emulator, Retropie, that ran pretty good. It's been so many years since I played, there's no way I could go back and play that game. Have to go through and configure the buttons somehow. It's not recognizing some of the buttons on the Xbox One controller. Okay, booting it back up here. All right, so I just don't like running this emulator because you have to hard power the Raspberry Pi off to get the hell out of the emulator. There's no button combination that I've found where it backs out of the emulator, which, okay, F0X doesn't even work. We'll try Smash Brothers. I was gonna say that looked promising on the damn title screen, how quick that title screen popped up. Maybe just lag sometimes like ravens. Let's see. 3, 2, 1. You know what? I'm sure it's running better than it did on the last version of this emulator. I mean, this not. There's no way you could play. I mean, if you really wanted to play it, you could play this, but no, that's way too slow. It's definitely getting there. I mean, whoever made this emulator, hey, keep up the good work. We'll get it eventually. Oh my God, I just found out how to exit that emulator. Okay, so start and select does not exit it like most of them. Pull the triggers on Xbox One controller, you can back out of the game. Sweet. Okay, so now we're going to try Conker's Bad Fur Day. Awesome, because I don't like hard resetting, you know, basically pulling the power cord on the Raspberry Pi. Definitely not good for it. Could corrupt the SD card, but okay, so this game is cool. I mean, if you really wanted to play this game, I would play it on the Rare Treasures or no, Rare Replay on the Xbox One.
Stupid logo.
God, I really wish Microsoft would do something with Conker. They're just sitting. They've got Rare. They've got the Rare name. They can have Conker. I would pre-order a Conker game day one. It's already choppy right there. Yeah, I think it's just going to be just like Smash Brothers. Like it's almost there, but not really. Close though, close. Skip this shit. Come on. trying to get to the gameplay now. Yeah, it's running choppy. It'll probably play the same, if not worse, than Smash Brothers. Let's try Cruisin' World. People didn't like this game. I was actually a fan. I had fun playing it. Choose your car. It wasn't as good as the arcade, but... Damn, it looks so promising, too. And if this runs like this, Cruisin' World and Cruisin' Exotica will probably work just the same, damn it. Yeah, that's, figure out what the button was on that, and that shit just ran way too shitty. Okay, now this is Samurai Showdown on the Neo Geo emulator. I'm sure Neo Geo does probably emulates pretty good. Uh-oh. Retropie seems to do really good on the 16, well, I'd say 32-bit and below consoles, like PlayStation, Super Nintendo, NES is probably perfect. Oh my god. Eventually, I'm going to have to go through and configure some of these, but I do want to beat some of these. Oh, what the fuck? I never had a Neo Geo. I don't think I played Samurai Showdown once on a Neo Geo anymore on PC. They feel pretty accurate to that emulator I pulled on PC with the speed test. Yeah, give me a fucking headache. Try Metal Slug and then be done with this emulator. Said I wasn't really a fan of Neo Geo, never really got into it. You know, it was so overpriced back in the day. Was it like a $500 console? It's ridiculous. Yeah, it feels pretty accurate. That's pretty good. The Neo Geo emulator seems pretty good. Back out here. Of course, Nintendo. You know, 8-bit. You should be able to emulate an 8-bit system, no problem. Shouldn't have to configure the buttons, really, either, because... You know, NES only had 2 buttons. You know, a lot of people aren't a fan of this. Like, I never owned this on my Nintendo. I borrowed it from friends that had it. It is kind of stupid, but you know what? I actually did have fun playing this game. There we go. Fucking shitty rock. The game's only really good when you get the fucking knife. I mean, even this, though, this seems like a waste of technology. I'm using, a console with 1 gig of RAM. I think it's got like a 900 megahertz CPU to fucking play NES. Oh, my knife. I remember you always had to remember about this game. Oh, what the hell? I was gonna say, the angry video game nerd pointed it out. The direction you go is backwards, but not right now, it's not. I'm heading to this cabin. Because Jason's killing kids, which is ridiculous, because in the movies he never killed a kid. He killed a dog. Oh, was that Michael Myers? I don't remember. Oh my god. Oh shit! Yeah, me and my brother once beat this game on Nintendo, but... beat it with the damn Game Genie. That game cheats. But it runs good. Glad to have it in my collection. Always had a lot of fun playing it. Let's see, we'll try... we'll try a real classic, what many consider the greatest game on the NES, Super Mario Bros. 3. Which, you know, I think I would agree with that. I had a lot of fun playing Mario Bros. 3. And Huku, forget the music. Oh yeah. The last time I played this game was probably Super Nintendo. I had Super Mario All-Star, so... so, I mean, it feels like... there's no way the one on Super Nintendo... felt like that. I think it felt a little different on the Super Nintendo, but this game's definitely playable, just like Friday the 13th on the NES emulator on Retropie. Alright, so there it is, Super Mario Bros. 3. I'm trying to remember some other popular games on here besides Mario. Oh, you know what? One of my personal favorites. Even though a lot of people didn't like it, I remember my parents got us this for our Nintendo. Stupid, though. It was a one-player Ninja Turtle game. One player. Come on. And it's ridiculous. You know, I'm sure my parents got it for thinking it was at least two players. Because he had three boys. So what do you think happened when people were playing this? There was fighting because, oh, he's taking too long. Oh, you know, oh, he's not. It's my turn now. It's my turn. But overall, you know, a lot of people didn't like the game. I actually like this game. I always liked it because when me and my brothers played, they could play for a while, but they always needed my help getting past the water stage. I was an expert at that water stage. And they didn't know how to beat Bebop. Was it Bebop or Rocksteady? Maybe it was Rocksteady, the one where you have to stand up on the top with Donnie with the staff and hit down and he doesn't hit you. I mean, this is another game that looks pixelated as shit. Okay, but anyway, that's Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. We'll try one more game. That was weird. I just saw Tournament Fighters. I didn't know that was on the NES. Maybe that's a hacked ROM or something. Oh, this was the shit right here because it was two players. Never had it. Borrowed it from my friends a lot. It's an awesome game. Not as good as the actual arcade game in the arcade. The graphics were definitely shittier. It didn't look as good. But not bad. I mean, it seems perfect. You know what? I know one other game I want to try. One of my top five games of all time. On the Nintendo, Mike Tyson's Punch-Out. This game was fucking awesome. Oh my god, was this game awesome. Me and my brother beat this game too, using the game genie, because Mike Tyson is a cheater. I'm sure this game will run better, just like all these other ones did. It's funny because the buttons are backwards. Oh shit. Damn. That's the easiest fucking guy too. Anyway, that's a Super Nintendo emulator. Runs perfect, right? You saw it. And then they have these ports. I tried them with a keyboard. You need a keyboard and mouse. Duke Nukem 3D, Quake 3 Arena. Ran pretty good on the Raspberry Pi. I don't have a controller hooked up right now, so I'm not even going to go into those. Well, I'll go back to PlayStation, but this is 32X. Sega's 32X. So Sega CD does not work. Sega's 32X. I might have tried it. I don't remember. But I just added Virtua Fighter. Wasn't a big fan of Virtua Fighter on here. Virtua Fighter was definitely better on the Saturn. Ready, go! Alright, well that's Sega Saturn. That ran about how I remember it. I remember playing it on another emulator. This was one of my favorite games on... I used to play it all the time on Super Nintendo. In the arcade, it was awesome too. WrestleMania, the arcade game by Midway. It's an awesome game. It's kind of like Mortal Kombat. You know, it's fast-paced, more arcadey. Razor Ramon! I think I ever played this on 32.
The next matchup, Razor Ramon versus Doink the Clown.
Gotta get in and configure the buttons for some of these games. That ran pretty good. Didn't run as good as the PlayStation version that I was playing on my other video. PlayStation version definitely ran a bit faster. I don't know if that's the 32X or the PlayStation, or if that's the emulator. I don't know.
Sub-Zero.
Never played Mortal Kombat 2 on the 32X either. Used to play it a lot on my friend's Genesis.
Round one, fight!
Well, the backgrounds don't even look as good as the... I gotta get rid of the buttons, but... The backgrounds don't even look as good as the CPU. Oh no, that background looks washed out compared to what I remember from the CPU.
Sub-Zero wins.
I guess the emulation ran good. I have no idea. Never played it. I mean, it ran fast enough. That's definitely playable. I mean, I played it on my PC and then I played it on Super Nintendo. Never played Knuckles KO. If it's like a normal slime game, it seems like a tad bit of maybe the game ran that way, but it seems a tad bit slower. Yeah, I just got feels a little sluggish to me. Feels a bit sluggish on me. That felt really weird. I don't know what the hell it was doing right there. Like I said, Sega CD doesn't work. Tried Sewer Shark, Sonic CD. Alright, so Scum VM, I don't even know what that is. PlayStation. See, I played WrestleMania arcade game is perfect. I figured I'd try one of my favorite games from the PlayStation, Tony Hawk's Pro Skater. I remember when this game came out, we didn't think it was going to be much. My brother got it for Christmas one year, and my God, we spent hours just skating on the top of the school in the swimming pools. The game had one of the best soundtracks. Yeah, we used to do a lot of free skating. You know, Tony Hawk, the game's got lame after, like, Tony Hawk. That's pretty cool. anyway, that's Tony Hawk's Pro Skater. Awesome game. Wanted to try. I'm not playing Crash Bash. I'll try Fighting Force though. I was gonna put the other Crash Bandicoots on here. They'll probably run good. The PlayStation emulator on here seems to be pretty spot on. This is weird. Running. Okay, just stop. But right when the game started, my controller vibrated like crazy. This is Fighting Force. This game was awesome. I remember I had this on, I think it was an emulator, when the Bleem emulator came out for PC. This was an awesome game. Part 2 was shitty. Because this game was cool because it was, if I remember correctly, yeah, it was multiplayer. And then Part 1 was single player. It's like it's a beat 'em up, which, by the way, Sega, please make another Streets of Rage. God, I'd buy that in a fucking second. So many licenses that Sega owns. Phantasy Star Online. Of course, you know, Sonic Mania is coming out. I don't know if I'm going to get that on the Switch or the Xbox One. Power Stone, Shenmue. Sega owns so many. It's like, take my money, Sega. I will buy these games. You announce a new Jet Set Radio, or Jet Grind Radio, whatever you want to call it, I will pre-order day one. You know, make it in 4K, make it a launch title for the Xbox One X when I pre-order my Xbox. Please, Sega, Streets of Rage. Please make another Streets of Rage, make another Power Stone. We got Shenmue coming out. Alright, this actually feels dead on. It feels a lot shittier than I remember like other games. I do remember playing with one of those games. 3D felt a little awkward at times. Because like some of the guys would stand at weird angles. Another thing I didn't like about some of these damn places, like the camera is so fucking weird, like, yeah, it automatically just spun around and gets you fucking killed. Another game that I think Siphon Filter is really fun. Alright, so anyway, that's Fighting Force. I still have quite a few games here. Showing how the emulator works. And actually, you know what? Now that I know how to back out of games, let me see if I can get. Let's see, Dreamcast. We'll try Sonic Adventure 2. Sonic Adventure 1 ran chopping, I think it froze. And it's a bummer. Where is the Dreamcast sound? That sound used to get me excited to play my Dreamcast when that popped up. Okay, but anyway. So we'll use that. Go all the way over. Come on. See it? I don't know. Does it have sound? No, I don't think it does. Yeah, see that? The Dreamcast emulator's. Oh, wait, did it go? Yeah, see, there's no sound, which is a bummer because. See, there's some slowdown there. Yeah, I don't know. Let's see if I unplug my Xbox controller. Because some games are weird, like, you don't recognize the Xbox controller, but man, it instantly, yeah. And see, I think that might be another game where you can't, let's see. Yeah, it's fucking weird. I have to hard reset it. But yeah, I mean, there's no sound anyway. You know what, though? It looks promising. I'm going to try to unplug my Xbox One controller. Reboot the emulator with the knockoff Super Nintendo controller. Which, I mean, it feels exactly like the Super Nintendo controller, just way lighter. Like, it feels like cheap-ass thin plastic, but it does the job for what I'm going to use it for, which is playing Super Nintendo, the Sega Genesis, maybe PlayStation. Might have enough buttons for play. Well, no, PlayStation had, what, double triggers? It's got almost enough buttons. Okay, so let me go back to the Dreamcast emulator. I mean, if nothing else, the sound's not working. I can at least show you if the gameplay is fast. So we'll go over. Come on. Yeah, that's, oh wait. Yeah, I can't even hit any buttons with that emulator. The start button doesn't even work. Eventually, you know, it'll get there. I don't want to hook a keyboard up to this, so. And I think that might be it. I said Crazy Taxi was weird. It wouldn't let me choose the video signal, so it froze. It forced me to stay with PAL and then went to the next screen and wouldn't do anything. Atari, I showed off Space Invaders. I showed off Super Nintendo on my other video. Yeah, I think that's it. Yeah, Tony Hawk, Fighting Force. But yeah, so that's Raspberry Pi 3 with Retropie. In my other video, I'll put a link in this video where I bought the kit. I didn't install the emulators myself. I bought the kit, everything put together, the two controllers, power cord, HDMI cable, and a mini wireless keyboard with a built-in mouse. For $98 off of eBay, and then I just put my own ROMs on it. All legal ROMs, of course. Because we can't, you know, condone piracy here. But that's, you know, that's the RetroPie in action. Works pretty good. I like it a lot. I'll use it a lot for Nintendo. Hopefully N64, if, you know, hopefully they get the kinks out of the emulator. Sega Genesis, definitely. And Super Nintendo, not Game Gear, it's too pixelated. Maybe on that smaller TV I videoed on upstairs, but Super Nintendo, definitely. I've never beat Super Mario RPG or Final Fantasy III on the Super on the American Super Nintendo. So definitely going to do that because I know Nintendo's going to pull that shit of not releasing enough SNES classic systems, which is bullshit. You know, everybody wants one. You know you're going to sell a million of them. Just release tons of them. Who cares? You're going to make money. Quit being an asshole. But anyway, appreciate you watching my video. You know, I hope if you were thinking of getting a Raspberry Pi, this is the unit number 3. I've watched videos on YouTube where if you overclock the processor in this through software, GoldenEye actually runs pretty decent. On mine, it runs choppy. I don't know if I showed that off. Actually, you know what? I'm going to go show that. I'm going to show you that real quick. Just what I'm talking about. I don't think I recorded that. But anyway, it runs choppy. If you overclock the processor, there's a guy on YouTube. You search for the video. He overclocked his processor, and it actually ran a lot better than it does on mine. But so, like I said, hopefully this video helps you make a decision if you want to get a Raspberry Pi for retro gaming. Sega CD doesn't work. Nintendo 64 still has some work to be done. You can play Mario 64, no problem. Mario 64 runs perfect. Wave Race runs pretty good. You can play Wave Race. Well, that was in warm-up. I don't know about that. Actually, you know what? I'll try that one also. But yeah, see, this game is already running choppy. But it's weird. Once you get past that main screen, it clears up, and you're like, oh, cool, I'm going to play it. But you know, there's no way you can play this game. No way. I mean, you would wait forever to shoot somebody. Because watch how choppy it runs, and there's like nobody on the screen. I'm just walking forward into the first level. Those rooms where there's 50 million guys, it would run at like 2 frames. Holy shit. Oh my god. Hell no. Oh god, I was fucking... Oh. There's no way you could play that game like that. But, you know, that's choppy. I mean, it's getting there. You know, I mean, even the PC emulators started out slow. They eventually sped them up. If you want to play Dreamcast, I recommend on PC downloading the Wave PC emulator. That's how I play Dreamcast. I have a computer sitting next to the TV I'm playing on, and that works awesome. Let's start the race. But, yeah.
Select your watercraft.
Works awesome. Null DC. And then if Nintendo 64,
Welcome to Sunny Beach.
I don't remember what it's called, but there's a few great emulators for the Nintendo 64 that run
ready for us.
That's what I used to play. Way back.
3, 2, 1.
Oh, they all run GoldenEye perfect. If you really wanted to play Way Back. Hopefully they'll put it on a virtual console. And I bought it on so many. And I bought it for the N64, I bought it on the Wii virtual console, I bought it on the Switch virtual console. If it doesn't transfer, I'm trying not to switch the Wii U virtual console, but I'll tell you what. Once they release on the virtual console for the Switch, if they ever do, and your purchase is from like Wii U, I'll buy the game again on the Switch. This is my favorite water racing game. I could play this game all day. When I had my Nintendo 64, I beat it on all the difficulties. Every damn race I got first place. That was some hard shit. It's a fun game. Yeah, this game runs good. This and Super Mario 64 run dead on. It's pretty much dead on. A little bit of slowdown here and there, but I mean, if you really wanted to play the game, you could definitely play this. Killing it right there, look at that. Having this damn booty. Man, the water effects in this game, even, I mean, you know, Nintendo 64 came out in 1996 in America. Those water graphics are still the best I've seen. Wave Race Blue Storm was pretty cool.
Welcome to Sunset Bay.
I don't know. Something about Wave Race 64.
Start your engine.
Even though the graphics like look kind of shitty nowadays, compared to the old games, but man, God, how different it is.
Okay. Good. Everybody,
I want to hit a ramp and see how that.
Maximum power.
Couldn't do a flip there. That was weird. Yeah, man, this game is really good. It's awesome. I can't hold my own this game. GoldenEye and Wave Race 64. Yeah. There's something with the analog controller. Hopefully the transfer over, like I said, it's not all the fire. This was one of my most played games. This GoldenEye and the WCW wrestling. Me and my brothers used to play these games for hours on the 64. Nope. Shitty, shitty, fuck. I mean, not that it matters. I don't think doing the flips and stuff actually did anything in this game. Like, yeah, look at how easy I made that list. But, like I said, there it is. Nintendo 64 emulator. Showed off all the emulators on here. For the most part. MS-DOS, I have nothing. PC Engine. Never really played PC Engine. Scum VM, I don't remember what that was. Sega CD does not work. 32X is good. Haven't tried... I haven't tried Cody on here. You know, Cody's for viewing pirated TV channels, which is supposed to be pretty cool. I've never really messed around with Cody. I have a Plex server on my house. So I don't really need that. Oh, wow. Damn. Oh, Cody must be Cody must be configured with the Super Nintendo controller. But, so anyway, I'm going to mess with this and see what this does. That's my video. Damn. Yeah. It's updating add-ons. So that's my video. For Raspberry Pi 3 Retropie with a bunch of emulators. If my video helped you decide on getting the Raspberry Pi 3, or even if you just wanted to know more about it, my video, you know, gave you information, because there were games I was playing that I didn't see any videos for. Like, I could have made a video for, I don't know, Final Fantasy 7. There's probably a video of people doing that. That's one of the most popular games, if not the most popular game on the Sony PlayStation for a lot of people. So that's why I pick, like, you know, nobody made videos for WWF, the arcade game. I love that game. I picked games I love, obscure games that maybe most people didn't play. Most people didn't think were that great. Me personally, I like them a lot. So, you know, if you liked my video, if it helped you choose anything, then, you know, hit me with a like. If you like my videos, you want to know when I come out with new ones, I come out with new ones here and there. I think after this, I'm probably going to make a record a video for come and play Splatoon for a few hours on the Switch, which is an awesome game, by the way. You know, hit it, you know, subscribe. I release new videos here and there. I don't do them every day or every week. Sometimes I do, but not consistently. Just, you know, if I see something cool or if I get, you know, a new game or something. Or, you know, like with the Raspberry Pi, I saw people on forums asking about game compatibility. I just wanted to show some of the games I like. So I appreciate you watching my videos. I appreciate the likes, the subs, and I'll see you in my next video. Thanks again for watching.